Hello dear students, and welcome to the last lecture of Financial Times series. Today, we will study state-space models. I'm very keen and excited because, well, as you might be aware, sequential Monte Carlo and state-space models are the topics of my PhD, 4 years of my life. We will also look at the Kalman filter, which is a recursive algorithm that allows us to carry over estimates for a specific subclass of state-space models, namely linear state-space models. But let's start from the definition of state-space models. A state-space model is defined by a couple of stochastic processes, Xt and Yt. Xt is the state, latent or hidden process, and Yt is the observation or observed process. These processes are linked in a very particular way. The hidden process is a simple Markov chain, but we only have access to these hidden states through a sequence of observations, Yt. These observations are conditionally independent, meaning that the distribution of Yt is independent to all the other observations given the state Xt. What we know about the structure of this model are the state transition density, the distribution of Xt given Xt minus 1, which is F, and the observation density, that are the distribution of Yt given Xt, which is G. State-space models represent a very wide class of models and are used in a variety of applications, including engineering, physics, biology, and of course, finance. A first example is object tracking, where the latent process is a target moving in space to which we have access to noisy observations, for example, through a radar. A second example is signal filtering, where the hidden process is a voice signal or a video, and the observed process is a very noisy version of this signal. In Financial Time series, the volatility is not observed, so we can treat the volatility process as the hidden process. The observed process can be the realized volatility, which is linked to the square of the returns of the stock, or the price itself can be the observed process, as the variability of the price process is linked to the underlying volatility. Given a state-space model, usually we are interested in three specific distributions, which are quite naturally defined. The first one is the filtering distribution, that is the distribution of the state at time t, xt, given all the observations up to time t. A second distribution we can be interested in is the predicting distribution, that is the distribution of the state at the next time, xt plus 1, given all the observations up to today. The third distribution of interest is the smoothing distribution, where we are interested in all the states up to the present, t, given all the observations up to the present. State-space models can be arbitrarily complex, depending on the transition density f and on the observation density g. We can be very high dimensional and don't have to be homogeneous in time, of course. But even the simplest state-space model, the linear Gaussian model, is extremely popular and useful. In the linear Gaussian model, the initial distribution of x1, the state transition densities, and the observation densities are all Gaussians. The linear Gaussian model can be considered the simplest state-space models, where we have that the state transition densities, so the distribution of xt given xt minus 1, are Gaussians, and so are the observation densities, so the distributions of yt given xt. Still, the linear Gaussian is a very popular and widely used model, in particular because through Kalman filtering, we can derive all the quantities of interest for this specific model, which are filtering distribution, the smoothing distribution, and the predicting distribution. Kalman filtering and linear Gaussian model are the topic of the last lecture of Financial Times series. I hope you enjoyed this short introduction to state-space model. Ciao! Gun kinda crazy, she's poison but tasty. And people say run.